I just want to point out that there are other variants of OLS, that is least squares. The original version is what we have discussed. Then came about a lot of other variants, like in any other typical research. You have weighted least squares, partial least squares, total least squares. There is no eclipsed least squares or anything like that. But you have non-linear least squares, generalized least squares, this least squares, that least squares, and so on, of which the two important ones of interest to us are the weighted least squares and the non-linear least squares. Okay. The weighted least squares differs from the ordinary least squares in only one aspect, and that aspect is, instead of solving a regular least squares problem, remember I said that ordinary least squares can be viewed as minimizing the sum square errors by giving equal importance to all observations, whereas in the weighted least squares, I would like to actually give different weights to different observations. When do we run into such situations? There are numerous situations, but at least if you think of two different situations, one is when you have heteroscedastic errors. What does heteroscedastic error mean? When your z is heteroscedastic, the variance is changing from observation to observation. That can happen in, remember, and the other thing that you should remember is, although we keep using this k here as an index in time, so when I write here k, for example, I write here zk, you should have a broader understanding of this k. This k need not be index in time. It is just an index of observations. For example, I may have 10 different sensors measuring the same thing in many critical units in many processes. For example, if you take a nuclear reactor, temperature of the reactor is a very critical variable. The industry does not rely just on one sensor. So if you go to IG car or any other, you know, plant which is running nuclear reactor, you would have 10 sensors reading this, because I don't trust just one sensor. If it fails, then that's it, you know, there is I won't be alive to see again why it has failed. So it is better to actually have many sensors, and then there are mechanisms to fuse this data that is coming together, and each sensor can have a different variance. So in practice, what is done is, I will take the average of all the sensors. Least squares estimate of that average would be simple average, simple mean. We know that sample mean is the solution, but that is only true if each sensor has the same level of reliability. But in general, that need not be true. I may have to actually give different weightings to different sensors. So that is one situation where, and that is the case of heteroscedastic errors. So the k need not be thinking be correlation just in time. Sorry, k need not keep track of time. K will allow you to also keep track of sensors. But in another situation, for example, in econometrics, it's very popular to have heteroscedastic errors on in some other applications. In those situations also, it is important to give different weightings to different observations. The other situation where weighted least squares would be required is when z is colored. So there are numerous reasons why we want to look at the weighted least squares. Fortunately, the solution to the weighted least squares can be obtained in one shot using the solution to the OLS. So I'll just show you the formulation here and the solution. It just takes a minute, that's it, and we'll adjourn. So this is the formulation now of the weighted least squares. Instead of minimizing y minus phi theta transpose times y minus phi theta, now we have a weighting matrix coming and sitting there. You can clearly see, if the weighting matrix is identity, then you go back to the OLS formulation. If the weighting matrix is diagonal with different weights, then you are giving importance, different, attaching different importance to levels of importance to different observations. The general case is when the weighting matrix is, this W is full matrix. But it cannot be any arbitrary full matrix. It has to be a positive definite matrix, because we want this objective function to remain convex, right? So generally, when we choose weighting matrices, we have to choose positive definite matrices, and that is ensured by choosing symmetric. Just choose W to be symmetric, and if you are in doubt, look at the eigenvalues of W. They should all be greater than 0. But what does the full W mean? Why should I use, why should I have off diagonal elements in W? Any idea? When I have errors that are correlated, right? There are, we talked about two different situations. One is heterostochastic errors, but the errors are not correlated in time. Individually, they have different variances. Then the other situation is errors are correlated. Then I may choose a W that is full matrix. Anyway, so choice of W we'll talk about later on. I just want to go over this solution. And all you do is, since W is positive definite, you do a Cholesky factorization. If you forget what a Cholesky factorization, just go and look up a book on matrix algebra. So you can factor a positive definite matrix into C transpose times C, where C is a Cholesky factor, so that I rewrite the objective function in this form. All I have to do now is to solve this problem, introduce the scaled data. So introduce scaled y, which is C times y, and scaled phi, which is C times phi, so that I can rewrite the WLS in terms of OLS, as an OLS in terms of the scaled variables. That's it. So once I have done this, I straight away get the solution to the weighted least squares problem. So that is a trick that is used widely in any estimation optimization problem. If I know the solution to one, I cast a new problem into an old one, but by moving into a new space. But that gives you a lot of insight. It says essentially that when you have data with varying errors, construct a new data by scaling appropriately, so that now your new data has errors of equal variance, for example, right? Now in your new domain, in your scale domain, the scale data have errors which are homostochastic. They have same errors, for example. The only million-dollar question is, who gives me W? Because all we are saying is, I assume I know W, and W has to be driven, as we will see tomorrow, is driven by the noise covariance matrix, sigma z. So in practice, we estimate this iteratively. We fit a model, get an estimate of sigma z, then apply the weighted least squares, and then solve iteratively. There are some special situations in which W is known a priori, where W is not driven by the error covariance, but something else. But in general, W is estimated iteratively along with theta. So that is weighted least squares. We'll just discuss for a few minutes tomorrow early on, and then conclude with nonlinear least squares. Okay? Thank you.